For the intro, we have a total of 6 chords, and then it goes into the main riff. So we start with, this is the G major 9 chord. You'll notice that you have this little cluster, A, B, D, F sharp. You can also think of it as a B minor 7, but putting the A on the bottom of the chord. All right, then we go to an F sharp 7 sharp 9, and the shape, we have an A sharp, E, and an A. Anytime you see a sharp 9 chord, you'll play this type of shape for the most part. And then from here, the bass notes just go down chromatic, and then we have a pattern. So this is an F major 9 chord. You can also include the E if you want to simplify the voicing, we're going to play an A, D, G. It's a fourth interval shape. And then from here, the thumb is just going to drop a half step to your E7 sharp 9. So F major 9, E7 sharp 9. And then we get to the E flat major 9 chord. Same shape that we played on F, but just transposed. And then again, the thumb drops. It's a really good exercise just for voicing and seeing how the half steps make the difference. So again, G major 9, F sharp, the F sharp sharp 9 chord, and then F major 9, E7 sharp 9 chord, E flat major 9, and then the D7 sharp 9 chord. And really the best way to do this is just practice these little 2 chord sequences. Then you have the chromatic bass line to top it all off. Alright, now it goes into the little chord rhythm sequence that continues into the verse. C major 7. And then you're going to drop the low notes in both hands at a step. And you're going to play this little fourth chord shape in the right hand, A, D, G. The right hand. And both notes go down a step. In the left hand, bottom note goes in a step, and then together. And then the rhythm is this kind of syncopated rhythm that's done a lot on these tunes. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, and then you hold that through the rest of the measure. Okay, all the way through the intro in time.